code, so you can build it, can build your code. And if the code, if your program or project so you can run it, right? So you can run it, you can get some results, so you can check this function. So this specifications are correct or not. So this is a school project. So in this chapter, we will see so how to be close to the industry level project. So in the industry level project, generally, so we don't try to build our project in the local machine. Generally, this project build is on
you can
the
see the
server.
Dirt and everything.
So this
what
is not
the
on local
hell?
Machine. So later, we will see some tools. And we will see some reasons why we don't build on the local machine, right? So this there are some because in the industry, so time is very limited, so we should work efficiently, right? So this is
part.
So we can go. So here, so actually, so there is a basic principle, right? Miller's law. So because of
issues. Jesus, oh my god, when did they come in?
We can divide the project into different
so
items.
Beautiful.
We can focus on different items at the same time.
Oh, sorry.
So this is here, so there is a sentence here. Postpone decisions as to details as late as possible to be late. To be able to concentrate on the important issues. So actually, so this is not a new topic. This
can I put them in my video?
In chapter 13, I'll
put Tristan too.
From abstract to compare to details, right? So this is a basic rule in modern software development.
Yeah, yeah,
so
I'm gonna do that.
Abstract.
You look
actually,
cute.
This is the base class.
Mashallah.
Right? A super class, right? So this is super class. So if you use the base class is a C++ knowledge, right? Super
dude,
class.
You can see the little
bubbles.
What the hell?
So
this
from
is
the base class, so it is abstract. We don't have some details, right? And then so you can
wait, how do I go back?
Derived class, right?
Okay.
In the derived class, so more details can be added.
Okay, this is
so for example, for your project, we can set up a base class, a person or human in the base class. So under this base class, we have two derived classes. Right? One is student class, one is faculty class. Right? So from the base class, so in this hierarchy, in this,
this is
class hierarchy, right? The top is base class. By base class is abstract. So in the bottom, so that derived classes. For derived classes, they are very detailed. So this is a basic rule from abstract to details, right? Try to postpone, right? This details as late as possible. At first, focus on the big picture, focus on the important issues, right? So in the class 13, so in the 13, so class diagram, so in the chapter 13, so actually, so we started some. We started the class diagram like this, right? So actually, this is one type of class diagram. So just put the class name in each class, right? We don't put any details because this is belonged to the analysis workflow. So after analysis workflow, so in the design workflow, right? We can add.
Oh my god, the gestures!
Like this, right?
This is
so
cool.
The top is the, this one is the class name.
I'm disappointed in you choosing the dark side.
So that means so from the analysis workflow
like
to the design workflow, this is also from abstract to details, right? We postpone details as late as possible. So
beautiful.
That means so in the chapter 13, we don't add